You understand the titles, the dukedom.
Duke of Edinburgh.
They're not the job. She is the job. She is the essence of your duty. Loving her. Protecting her.
I'd like you to come aboard my coronation committee.
What would it entail?
Inspire everyone. Lead them.
We have a new sovereign, young and a woman. Let us give her a coronation that is befitting of the wind of change that she represents.
The people look to the monarchy for something bigger than themselves, an inspiration, a higher ideal. If you put it in their homes, allow them to watch it with their dinner on their laps.
Democratize it. Make them feel that they're sharing it. Understand it.
All right. I'll support you in the terrorizing. On one condition, that you kneel.
What kind of marriage is this? You've taken my career from me. You've taken my home. You've taken my name.
Are you my wife or my queen?
I'm both.
I will not kneel before my wife.
Your wife is not asking you to.
But my queen commands me.
Yes.
I beg you, make an exception for me.
No. The only person I have ever loved is you. And can you honestly look me in the eye and say the same? Can you? I've learned more about humiliation in the past few weeks than I hoped I would in a lifetime. I've never felt more alone than I have in the past 5 months. So what would make it easier on you? To be in, not out. What will it take?
The Duke of Edinburgh shall henceforth be known as His Royal Highness, the Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh.
10 years has taught me the secret of a successful marriage is actually to have different interests.
It's a funny business. One sees the whole of the other person. You see even that part of them that they don't see themselves, and presumably they see that hidden part of you.
I know exactly what my job is. Your father made it perfectly clear. You are my job. You are the essence of my duty. So here I am, liege man of life and limb. In, not out. I'm yours. In. And not because you've given me a title, not because we've come to an agreement. Because I love you.
The first 25 years of marriage have rather crept up on us. I'm not much given to philosophizing, but from time to time, one is presented with an opportunity to reflect upon what has contributed to the success of something. And in the case of our marriage, it's family. The rock upon which any enduring marriage must surely be founded. Fealty, allegiance, obedience, and devotion. Marriage is a proposition some in the modern world would question. But it is a proposition about which, when asked, I can reply plainly and unequivocally. I am for it.
It must be hard getting old.
Yes. To realize that elusive state of being a happy family is a tireless struggle, a battle. But it is a battle worth fighting.
I'll be up in a minute.
Oh, will you?
Yes, I thought so. Unless you'd rather I wasn't.
I'll see you in a minute.
The right kind of partnership, with the right kind of partner, is the foundation on which a successful family must rest.
What's that look?
Gratitude. Appreciation.
What for?
You make a better person of me.
And you of me. Isn't that the point of marriage?
Hi, Elizabeth Alexandra Mary.
Take thee, Philip.
Take thee, Philip.
To my wedded husband.
To my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish and to obey.
To love and cherish and obey.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
There you are!
Yes. Here I still am.
You are one of a kind. We're a dying breed, you and I. Oh, I'm sure everyone will carry on pretending all is well. But the party's over. The good news is that while Rome burns and the temple falls, we will sleep, dearie, sleep.
Oh, you looked.
A piper's lament. Your sole musical choice. It's very you.
And your coffin being driven in an old Land Rover is very you.
Oh, you looked.
I did.
Well. I'll leave you to it. Say one for me?